Peace Path 4, Kingdoms. Refinement. I have come to understand that the web of love that passes through all life has been imprinted by all kingdoms through all time. Hence, all knowledge is held in this matrix, and what we focus on we draw out of this invisible inner plane web into the visible world. How we view or experience this matrix is always a changing panorama that reflects the expansion or contraction of our own consciousness. We can feel and see the discordant rhythms in the fields that pulse there as a reflection of the dominant consciousness of humankind and the status quo belief systems, or we can refine ourselves further into subtler realms and see and feel a new beat altogether. All of it depends on what we hunger for. Are we hungry or ready for and open to enjoy the path of peace? Kingdoms. We have introduced concepts we hope are well known, things to think of as we sit on our throne, counting our blessings having claimed new space. We sit and enjoy a sweet flow of grace. It's time to go further with the new path of peace, being king of your kingdom, a king in deep bliss. Self-knowledge, of course, so the game can be played without fear or ego or things that delay. So take up the mantle if you think that you can. It's about being king or queen of your clan. To be your own master in self-sovereignty now, fully realized, contented, aware of the how. Compliant to universal laws, committed to a greater cause. If you were the king or that sweet queen of your inner kingdom, the seen and unseen, how would you be? How would your life seem? Is there courage in your heart and will you rule wisely since you are a part of something that's rising? Will you bow in homage when you feel love's true spell? Will you listen to its voice, the one once known well? Can you unite your male-female being with inner marriage, androgyny seeing, balanced, united with our inner child, merged and mated, placating the wild? There is a rhythm in the matrix we've found, something so peace-filled that seems to abound within all queens and kings on their thrones, if their hearts are pure and their visions are sound. So take up the mantle if you feel that you can. It's time to be king, the queen of your clan. To be our own master in self-sovereignty now, fully realized, contented, aware of the how. Compliant to universal laws, committed to a greater cause. Pragmatic exercises for Peace Path 4, Kingdoms. Meditate on the kingdom's poem and hold the intention that you receive the perfect insights from it. Absorb from this poem exactly what feels right for you. Take a good look at your kingdom and the time that you spend within it. There are 168 hours per week, as we know, 24 in a day. So in your journal, write out the major things in your life and how much time you spend on each, and then, if possible, grade each as a percentage. So how much time do you spend on or with your family? How many hours per day or each work? And how much does this equal as a percentage of your time? How much time do you spend on your health, including your exercise routines? How much time do you spend on your career and work? On basic life maintenance like bill paying and shopping? How much time do you spend on personal downtime, on your hobbies, relaxation time, and maybe even personal pampering? Again, looking at each one as how many hours per day or week and what this equals as a percentage of your time. How many hours do you spend on your friends and socialization? How much time on your spiritual experience? How much time do you spend on sleep? Remember, many people spend 20 to 30% of their time in life sleeping. How much time do you spend preparing food, eating, cleaning up afterwards? How much time is spent on travel to and from work, including getting ready to go to work? When you have done this assessment, transfer the amounts onto a circle with segments like a pie graph. If possible, assign a color to each section. Make a graph. Remember that some of the things that you do in life will overlap and share time, like eating while being with friends or family, or socializing while indulging in hobbies. Once done, look to see if the graph and the time segments are balanced to your liking. If not, assess then change the percentage of time spent where you can, so that you can create more balance and satisfaction in your life. Next, we look at the community and family web. Again, do the same circle type graph in your journal as you did with your personal web in the space claiming exercises. Do this web now in this section to assess what you are involved with in your family and also your community web. What realities do you support in your family community web currently? Assess each one to see if they bring harmony or discord to your life and why. Is there anything in your family community web that brings discord to your life right now? If so, what can you responsibly walk away from if required, so that you feel more peace in life? This is a question to assess if we are sometimes over-involved in something, like being too much of a hands-on parent with adult children. What can you attend to better and refine in your family community web so that each connection and interaction works more harmoniously for everyone in your kingdom? And how do you sense that you can do this and make this change so that your kingdom and your relationships within it run more smoothly? Next, we look at the global web in our kingdom. We do all feel as if we are the center of the universe, and we are as such kings and queens of our realm. We also affect community and global webs. So do the same circle type graph to assess what you are involved in globally on a planetary level. What realities and major belief systems do you support in the world? Are these beneficial to all life here? Is there anything in the planetary web and your position within it that brings discord to your life? What global realities can you responsibly walk away from? For example, watching negative global media and hence getting caught up in fear paradigms. And what global reality streams can you energetically hook more into to increase personal and planetary peace and harmony levels? Maybe tithing more to a charity to help educate and take care of Earth's children. Next, what relationships within the planetary web can you contribute to harmoniously so that our whole planet can claim a new space of enhancement in the matrix? And how do you sense that you can do this? What attributes can you develop within your personal web so that it contributes more harmoniously to the greater pool it lives within, which are the global and universal webs? Also, assess what is your field of influence in your family, community, and planetary webs. What about the universal and multidimensional webs? What impact do you have there with your personal energy emanations? Is there a negative fallout to others in your energy fields with things that you do or realities that you hold? Can you refine these so everything exists more harmoniously and peacefully within you and around you. To help you feel more supported with all that you do and wish to do in your new kingdom, we have also provided some additional meditations, which again can be downloaded from our iTunes channel. Firstly, the Angelic Support Systems Meditation. This meditation is about connecting with inner plane, higher dimensional support systems, guides, angels, and more, so that you feel more supported as you fulfill what you have come to do in this dimension, in your kingdom. Plus, it also helps you to manifest a more grace-filled life. Also, we have the Gaia and Indigenous Connection Meditation. This is a meditation designed for knowing the kingdom of Mother Earth and tuning more deeply to the essence of her spirit, Gaia, so that we can live a more harmonious existence with all. It is also for connecting with the Rainbow Serpent of Wisdom, the Indigenous Elders, the Dream Weavers and Dream Keepers beyond time, to aid our world into a smoother transition into the higher kingdoms and paradigms. At this time on Earth, we need to be more aware of Mother Earth and what she needs, and we need to learn to use her resources more wisely.